This weekend, we're in Belgium, in the picturesque province of Liège. Halfway through the season, it's too early to call the championship. Can teams make good before the summer break, or will they be hoping for a reset?
Red Bull have outscored their rivals to be at the top of the constructors' table right now. And as the final round begins, what a season it's been.
Let's see what the weekend has in store.
go off grid. Check. Copy. Yes, all good.
Copy.
How is the feeling? Copy that. feels pretty good. We will go on green. Yeah. Okay, that's VSD. Keep an eye on the Delta. VSC ending.
Yeah, copy.
There's tension in the air today, so it must be time for qualifying.
Qualifying at Spa is one of the most exciting sessions of the year, and the season's longest lap leaves little margin for error. Drivers need to give it their all whilst avoiding any mistakes.
In terms of Lance Stroll, how do you think he's doing, Karun?
Looking at the lap times, we saw a real lack of pace from them in practice. They never looked quite comfortable with the setup, and they'll need to try something new for qualifying if they want to get past Q1.
Here we go, folks. It's time to get started. Well, it's a fantastic turnout, as it always is here in Belgium, as we prepare for 44 laps around Spa.
Motor car racing didn't have the best of starts at Spa-Francorchamps. Only one driver registered for the very first car race back in 1921, so a motorbike race replaced it instead. Times have changed, and now Spa is a solid fixture on the F1 calendar.
Spa-Francorchamps should need no introduction. From the sweeping curve of Eau Rouge and Radion to the flat-out descent through Pouhon, this is just over 4 miles of wonderful racing wherever you look in the Belgian countryside. The teams are making their final preparations down in the pit lane ahead of today's race. Thank you. Well then, it's not long until we get started here, and we should be in for a tightly contested race. Our attention shifts to Lewis Hamilton and what he can produce in this race.
Being seventh on the grid gives them a good advantage. This is a great opportunity for points.
But there's no more time left. We've got a race on our hands. Get ready, it's the Belgian Grand Prix. It's lights out and away we go.
Okay, good lad, well done.
Let's see what happened there. Now, this happened down at turn 8. The brakes couldn't cope. What caused that, I wonder? We've got a yellow flag here.
And you've got a new pet after that.
Great job.
Okay, copy.
update. We'll find. up the pace a little bit if you can, please.
Struggling
a bit with
rear, but can still hold on.
Won't be long.
Yeah,
copy. And there's been a slow pit stop. Something's not gone right in the pits.
We're going to box this lap.
Right then, you can take a look now. It all starts as they reach turn 17. And the car just locks, just unable to control the car by that point.
In the pit. Thank you. Copy.
Oh.
He'll take deployment.
Ours are okay.
Thank you.
let's go.
Copy, mate.
Tire management will be very important.
Copy.
Okay, no more management. Ready?
Copy.
Big push, big push.
Copy. Copy.
Copy. happy with this so far. Box this lap, please. Confirm.
Box.
VSC. What's the Delta, please?
Copy. I'm in the wall.
Now, there's been an issue in the pits.
Copy.
VSG ending, be ready.
Okay, copy.
Right, let's have a look as we go into turn four. And that won't help their chances. Perhaps a little lapse in concentration, maybe.
These tyres are a bit on the cool side. Look good.
Copy.
Copy. flags. Maintain that, please.
Close the rear.
Right, we're down at turn 5. And there goes the steering. Now, they did leave it very late.
Copy. Quite pleased with the temp that we have here. Copy.
Thank you.
why the engine feels really slow. Starting to go a bit for me.
Max Verstappen over the finish line and today's winner.
Okay, check the flag.
And after the checkered flag has flown, there's Nico Hülkenberg.
A dismal end. P7. P20 with very little promise, it's got to be said.
And a podium finish for the Red Bull driver will definitely help them build momentum going forward.
And that victory takes them into double figures for the year. An incredible 10th win of the season.
And there you have it. A smiley podium lineup at the Belgian Grand Prix. Well, Karun, how do you think they'll be feeling in the team garage at the end of that?
It was a strangely mixed weekend for them. We saw one driver put in a strong performance, but it was a different story for the other. Definitely positives there, though.
And that is that for this weekend's F1 action here in Belgium.
For the next round, Formula One won't be straying too far. We'll be heading to the dunes of Zandvoort and the lightning speeds of the Dutch Grand Prix.